endometriosis is a chronic, often debilitating gynecological disease that affects about 1 in 10 women and can cause significant negative effects on patients, their families, and society as a whole. Although it is most commonly diagnosed in women in their 30s and 40s, endometriosis can also affect women over 50 and postmenopausal women. With the guidance of patients, researchers, and clinical experts, the Society for Women's Health Research has designed a toolkit to assist individuals with endometriosis in navigating their care. Our Endometriosis Toolkit is a patient empowerment guide that provides easy-to-understand information and resources on menstrual health and stigma, understanding endometriosis, diagnosing and treating endometriosis, navigating endometriosis through the teenage years, pregnancy, and menopause, and managing a healthy lifestyle with endometriosis. This segment focuses on endometriosis and menopause. In endometriosis, tissue that resembles the lining of the uterus grows outside the uterus where it doesn't belong, forming a type of lesion called an implant. These lesions thicken and bleed during the monthly menstrual cycle, causing swelling, pain, and irritation to surrounding healthy tissues. Although menopause alleviates the symptoms of endometriosis for most women, some will continue to experience symptoms or even develop endometriosis after menopause. More than 200 million women worldwide are living with endometriosis, and approximately 1 in every 20 of these patients are postmenopausal. As a woman gets older, typically in her late 40s or 50s, her ovaries produce less of the hormone estrogen. Her menstrual cycle begins to change and eventually stops, resulting in menopause. This drop in estrogen can result in relief from endometriosis symptoms. However, because the body still makes small amounts of estrogen, some women continue to have symptoms after menopause. Surgical procedures that damage or remove your ovaries, such as during a hysterectomy or oophorectomy, can also induce menopause regardless of age. Hormone replacement therapy is commonly used to treat menopausal symptoms by supplementing the estrogen that the body has stopped making, which might reactivate pain and other endometriosis symptoms. Symptoms commonly experienced by women with endometriosis include abnormal pelvic pain, gastrointestinal issues such as bloating, constipation, or diarrhea, and ovarian cysts. Up to 19% of women over the age of 40 who are undergoing the menopausal transition and have unclear pelvic pain may have endometriosis. Just like patients in any other stage of life, the most important aspect to treating postmenopausal endometriosis is tracking symptoms and talking to a healthcare provider about any changes or pain experienced. If you experience abnormal symptoms after menopause, consult your doctor and discuss a treatment plan that is appropriate for your age and lifestyle. Some questions you might want to ask include, how can I know if what I'm experiencing is endometriosis or some other condition? Can any of my current medications negatively affect my endometriosis? What minimally invasive treatment options or alternative therapies do you recommend I try? And where can I go to learn more about endometriosis? Preparing in advance for your healthcare appointments and advocating for your own health may help you overcome potential hurdles to diagnosing and treating your endometriosis. A doctor's visit worksheet is provided in the appendix of SWHR's Endometriosis Toolkit for you to fill out and take with you on your visit. You should be prepared to discuss your symptoms and their impact on your day-to-day activities, your medical history, including reproductive history, family history, and past gynecological tests, treatments, or surgeries, and your current medications and other healthcare professionals you see. There is no cure for endometriosis, but here are some strategies to help you maintain an active and healthy lifestyle along your journey. Take breaks. Stress and anxiety can increase muscle tension and inflammation that can flare up endometriosis symptoms and pain. Take many standing or sitting breaks throughout your day to keep your body limber. Schedule opportunities to recharge your body and mind. Snack well. Healthy eating and drinking behaviors can reduce inflammation and manage nausea and bowel issues associated with endometriosis. Think fiber, fruits, veggies, and healthy fats. Make sure to drink plenty of water during the day and reduce your caffeine and alcohol intake. Talk about it. Speak with your partner about how you are feeling physically and emotionally, and sit down together to figure out ways to make sex and intimacy work better for both of you. To help with pain during or after sex, try taking a pain reliever 1 hour before intercourse. You might consider taking your partner with you to consultations with your healthcare provider. Ask for help. You don't have to battle endometriosis alone. Find a confidant or two with whom you can share your experiences and concerns. Ask them to hold you accountable for maintaining your health and wellness. You can also explore local or virtual support groups. Ask your doctor or search online for additional resources. For more information about endometriosis, or to download a copy of SWHR's Endometriosis Toolkit, a patient empowerment guide, visit our website, www.swhr.org. We also invite you to follow us on social media or sign up for a newsletter to get the latest in science, education, and policy concerning important women's health topics. The Society for Women's Health Research would like to thank everyone who contributed to the development of this toolkit, especially our Endometriosis Network, House Cat Creative Publishing, LLC, and programmatic sponsor, AbbVie.